Captain Marvel is a certified hit movie. Whereas, you know, in the beginning, the question was, you know, will this movie reach $1 billion? Or I don't think this movie can reach $1 billion. To, yeah, it's going to hit it. Like, it's just a question of when, you know, at this point. Because the opening box office was so strong. And, you know, its second weekend drop off was average. Like, it wasn't huge. It wasn't, like, you know, really low. It was what's to be expected with a lot of superhero movies these days. So the movie is going to reach $1 billion. I don't know if it'll, like, get too far over that, but it's going to get there. And so, you know, when you're a superhero movie that reaches $1 billion, you are successful. However, in spite of that, I do think that Marvel really needs to work hard to make sure that Captain Marvel 2... They shouldn't act like Captain Marvel 2 is, like, you know, a guaranteed success. Because this first Captain Marvel movie, as someone who's seen it, I thought it was very mediocre. And I think the only reason it became as successful as it did is because a lot of people wanted to see, you know, how it connected to Endgame, which comes out next month. And it was kind of like an Endgame appetizer, and almost some people like an Endgame prequel, right? They wanted to see, you know, how Captain Marvel, because she's a cosmic hero and is supposed to be in Endgame, you know, how she would be introduced, whether or not the things that happen in, like, Captain Marvel, the story threads or characters or just other things, the plot would carry over into Endgame. And since Endgame is probably going to be the biggest movie of the year and all these people are waiting for it, they were like, well, I have to see this movie that comes out before it that might, you know, might have a storyline that I need to see to get ready for Endgame, right? Marvel brilliantly, very smartly attached Captain Marvel to a highly anticipated movie to help Captain Marvel seem more like a must-see movie to complete the Endgame storyline, you know, the Endgame Infinity War storyline. And I think that's the main reason why the movie reached $1 billion. Whereas if Captain Marvel had been released, you know, another time, another year, and to stand on its own 2 feet the same way that, like, Ant-Man or Doctor Strange had to, I'm not sure it would make $1 billion on its own, because I don't think that Captain Marvel is a really great movie. It's okay. I mean, in my review of it, I thought it was extremely average. It was, like, it met the bare minimum requirements, I think, to be a passable superhero movie. And I think because of that, if Captain Marvel did, you know, have to stand on its own 2 feet, I don't think it would reach $1 billion. But because it has the Avengers Endgame glow to it, and all these MCU fans have to see, you know, how it connects, you know, to this chapter of Endgame, you know, I can't miss Captain Marvel because, you know, it might have, you know, clues about what's going to happen with Thanos and stuff in the next movie, they had to go see it. And I think that's why Captain Marvel became so big. Whereas, you know, if it had to stand on its own 2 feet like other superhero movies have, usually have to do, I don't think we'd be that successful. So for Captain Marvel 2, I think that Marvel really needs to make sure that the script, they've just got to make it just more than the bare minimum basic superhero movie. And I also think that they have to really, really accentuate, they have to pull, like, things out of Brie Larson so that she doesn't seem so wooden. I think Brie Larson, in my opinion, seemed uncomfortable playing a character like Carol Danvers. You know, maybe she had to get used to being a superhero or something, because Brie Larson, this is the first movie of this type I think Brie Larson's done. So maybe instead of trying to make Brie Larson fit Carol Danvers or whatever, or fit this mold, maybe change things to, you know, find what works in Brie Larson's own personality, like her personal essence, and make the character of Captain Marvel and Carol Danvers fit her, right? Because I think that if Brie Larson, if Carol Danvers and Captain Marvel is, as Kevin Feige says, going to be the leader or the face, the main star of the MCU going forward, she can't be, you know, a block of wood on the screen. That's not going to work. Especially if, you know, we're going to get people like the X-Men, the Fantastic Four, you know, with new actors who are presumably potentially going to be awesome and spectacular and charismatic on their own, they would threaten to upend, I think, her status, her supposed status as, like, you know, the main character of the MCU going forward. And, you know, future Avengers, right? There's going to be more Avengers movies coming out, you know, Doctor Strange 2, and there's going to be other characters in the Avengers family who will come out. And, you know, they could do the same thing. So I really think they need to work on, you know, either loosening Brie Larson up or finding, you know, working with, you know, her, I guess, more, I guess, kind of stiff persona sometimes, and finding a way to accentuate that so that she really is, in terms of presence and charisma, you know, fitting the leader of a huge cinematic franchise. That's my opinion. I know a lot of people loved Captain Marvel, and they would be fine, you know, everything's just fine, don't change a thing. But, I don't know, as someone who thought Captain Marvel was just okay, I think that Marvel needs to make sure that Captain Marvel 2 and the character of Captain Marvel herself is really like an A-list character going forward. They shouldn't just, you know, take it in their stride and be like, we got this in the bag the way it is. I think they shouldn't be too comfortable. They still need to, you know, bring their A-game and try to make sure Captain Marvel 2 is, you know, an awesome movie. Because unless they have another big movie coming up that they can attach it to like they did with Endgame. Because Marvel has been, you know, secretive with their Phase 4 plans. I think at this point they know which movies are going to make, but they haven't announced it yet because they're waiting for Endgame to come out first before they, you know, talk about, here's Phase 4. So, you know, maybe they already know. They did just hire back James Gunn, right, who's supposed to be their cosmic mastermind. So maybe they're going to do some kind of series, like, from the comics, like Annihilation or Secret Invasion. And, you know, they'll attach Captain Marvel 2 to that, like, to be as the starting point for this next, you know, huge crossover. So if that's the case, then I guess, you know, they'll be just fine. You know, they can just do the same thing. Just attach Captain Marvel to another guaranteed huge crossover movie, and it'll be sure to make $1 billion, no matter how mediocre it is. But that's just my 2 cents, or $2.50, about what I think that Marvel should do with Captain Marvel 2, and the character of Captain Marvel going forward. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please like it on YouTube and subscribe to the channel, because I appreciate your viewership, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.